In October 1980, the United States Army officially activated the National Training Center at Fort Irwin, California, to train armored brigade combat teams to win the first fight. NTC is located in the Mojave Desert of Southern California, roughly 35 miles northeast of Barstow. Each year, approximately 10 brigade-sized units that range from 3,000 to 5,000 soldiers come to NTC on what are known as rotations to achieve the highest state of readiness before heading overseas on deployment. Units typically live and train at NTC for approximately 30 days. 14 of those days are spent in the most realistic training environment the United States Army has to offer. This training requires a massive fleet of Humvees, trucks, and various equipment to support the field exercises. DynCorp International, through the LOGCAP contract, supports and supplies the vehicles, fuel, water, ammunition, logistics, and other essential components to ensure each unit has everything it needs for a successful training event. This is a brief overview of the full life cycle of a typical NTC experience. It all begins in the grid, also known as the draw yard. This is where DI issues more than 1,300 pieces of equipment to the rotational training unit at the beginning of each training cycle. Thousands of soldiers are briefed on the process of locating, inspecting, testing, and signing for their assigned vehicle or equipment. Upon completion of the process, the vehicles and equipment are the unit's responsibility for the remainder of the training. In the middle of the Mojave Desert, far from civilization, the training area, known as the box, is where the action takes place. Training is executed in a battlefield simulated environment that includes civilians, media, host country representatives, guerrilla forces, provincial reconstruction teams, weapons of mass effects, and even war crimes. DynCorp International monitors all sustainment actions in the training area from a remote command center in conjunction with Army and civilian representatives. DI supply convoys transport nearly all classes of supplies to the main supply distribution points. This allows the units to keep the focus where it belongs, on the training experience. At the end of the training cycle, all equipment rolls back into the rotational unit field maintenance area, where the final step of regeneration, or regen, begins. Soldiers work with the DynCorp International team to refuel, wash, repair, and inspect the equipment prior to turn-in. Back in the control of DynCorp International, the equipment must then be recertified for issue to the next rotational training unit. This 8 to 12 day turnaround is a massive and complex operation where every tactical heavy wheel, light wheel, track, and civilian vehicle is sent to various shops across the installation to receive services and repairs. The process requires a high degree of logistical efficiency and innovation. One example is the Humvee semi-annual services pulse line, which delivers maximum productivity while ensuring quality services. In addition to NTC, DynCorp International also supports LOGCAP operations in southern Afghanistan and at the Ronald Reagan Missile Defense Test Site at the Kwajalein Atoll in the Marshall Islands, providing a broad range of support services for U.S. and allied forces during combat, peacekeeping, humanitarian, and training operations. The logistics and maintenance provided by DI LOGCAP at NTC has drastically improved operational readiness, improved quality and service, reduced cost, and enabled our soldiers to be trained and ready to win the first fight.